सुचिर, फोकस। Looks like the petrol prices are going to increase again in next 2 days. Sujit, please remind me to get the car filled when I drop you to school.
Yes. Thai, petrol prices are increasing day by day, isn't it?
Yes, indeed. And that's why I, Anuja Thai, Isha Thai, we share our cars to work on weekly basis, right? And this week, it is my turn to take all of us to office, so I have to get the car refueled before the price hike.
But why are the petrol prices increasing frequently?
Well, there are many reasons for that, but in a simple way, I can tell you that the consumption and need for petrol is increasing, but the production of petrol is limited.
Thai, can't all the fuel factories produce more petrol so the prices will come down?
Of course. Yeah, your logic is right, but you see, petrol is obtained by refining of petroleum, a fossil fuel, which is a non-renewable natural resource that is present in only certain regions of the world. And petroleum reservoirs in nature have depleted considerably.
Oh, Thai, didn't get a word. English, please.
Okay, so you tell me, what do you understand by natural resources?
I have read this term in our science textbook. I know that natural means something that is available or present in nature around us. But we have not been taught that chapter yet, so I can't say what is a natural resource.
Well, that's okay. See, natural means anything that exists in nature on its own account without contribution of any human activity, okay? Resource means stock, store, or supply of things or materials. So, natural resource is a term used for supply, stocks, or stores of materials or energy that is available in nature for use by us.
Thai, is petrol a natural resource?
Indirectly, yes. See, petrol, gasoline, diesel, kerosene are fuels that are obtained by extraction, distillation, and refining of fossil fuel reservoirs, termed as petroleum or crude oil, or mineral oil in factories and refineries.
But Thai, you also said no renewable resources.
No, I did not say no renew resource. I said non-renewable natural resource.
Yes. What is a non-renewable natural resource?
Okay, before I answer that, can you tell me how fossil fuels are formed?
No idea.
Okay.
See, as the name suggests, fossil fuels are formed from the dead remains of plant and animal matter, that is fossils, which got compressed and decomposed deep under the earth's surface for many years. The pressure and heat inside the deep layers of soil and rocks over a very long period of time slowly converts the dead remains of living organisms to fossil fuels. This means all the fossil fuels that we have been using since few hundred or thousands years have been formed in nature over a period of millions of years. In other words, all the dead matter that is lying buried today deep inside the earth's surface will form fossil fuel only after millions of years. So now, do you realize that as these fuel resources are not easily formed in nature within short period of time, their stock or supply keeps diminishing with time and use. Hence, we use the term non-renewable natural resources for them. Get it?
Okay. Are there any other non-renewable natural resources which we use other than fossil fuels?
Yes, of course. There are vast varieties of minerals, metals, non-metals, and their compounds that occur in soil, sediments, or rock formations of lithosphere and hydrosphere are also non-renewable natural resources. Do you know that the table salt and rock salts we use routinely in our foods are obtained from non-renewable natural resource? Can you think of some more examples of materials obtained from non-renewable natural resources?
I guess the metals like iron, aluminium, gold, copper, silver, manganese, uranium and their compounds are examples of non-renewable natural resources.
Yes, right? Thank you.